Good day folks, this is Sijish here, and in this video I will walk you through the process of integrating Ambari with Active Directory. So I'm running with a cluster with Ambari 2.6. So we can check the version here. So it's 2.6.0 and HDP version is 2.6.3. And I already integrated this with Active Directory. Actually I enabled the Kerberos from Active Directory, so I'm using this Kerberos from Active Directory. So here we will walk through the integration of Active Directory with Ambari. So if you look into this, so Ambari, manage Ambari, then you can see the users and group here. Users here and group. So initially there is no groups, only one user admin. So this user, you can see the status is like local. So this user is available inside that local database of Ambari. So we will see how we can integrate Active Directory with Ambari so that we can use Active Directory users and group membership to authenticate with Ambari. So instead of using admin credential, you can use that credential. So let me log out from here and open a browser and continue the process. So from the terminal, execute this command, Ambari server setup LDAP. So it will ask a few parameters, and you have to enter the values properly. So this is the IP address of the LDAP service, 192.168.232.155. So this is the IP address of my Active Directory. So that's it. So use that, 389. So this is the port Active Directory is using. Enter that. So if you have a secondary LDAP service, just you can use that, else leave it. So SSL false. So object class, so this is POSIX account, but instead of POSIX account I have to use user, object class as user. So username attribute, instead of user this same account name, so this one I have to use here, so instead of user ID. Then group object class, so that is group. So group name attribute CN. Then a group member attribute, just use member. So distinguish name attribute, just use distinguish name. Then the base DN, so this is the tree where we need to start the search. So I'm just using DC equal to Hadoop comma DC equal to com. So it will search the entire tree. Then referral method, so follow or ignore, so use the default one. Bind anonymously false. Okay, so I think handling username collision, just use default. So manager DN. So manager DN, this is the the manager which we are using here is this one. So go to the service account and HDP, just click properties, then attribute, then get the full name. Okay, so CN equal to, this is the one which we need. So CN equal to HDP, O equal to service underscore accounts, DC equal to Hadoop, and DC is equal to com. So use this. So CN equal to HDP. So OU equal to service underscore accounts, DC equal to Hadoop, DC equal to com. So OU CN equal to HDP. So OU equal to service underscore accounts, DC equal to Hadoop, and DC equal to com, right? So the password for this user. Okay, so we have to save this. Yes, then that's it. Now I can restart Ambari server. So service Ambari server restart. So it will take some time. So Ambari has to restart. Okay, so that's it. I have restarted the Ambari. So now if you look in here and check the users. Okay, so it is not synced by default. Okay. But for syncing the user, so you need to separately execute by using certain commands. So I'm just using a file with a list of users. Okay, so users.txt, and I'm writing the username test user one. Okay, so this is the user which is available in this one, and username. So the username is test user one, right? So I just say return that, then Ambari hyphen server sync hyphen ldap hyphen hyphen users, then users.txt. So it asks for the password. So here you have to provide your Ambari admin credential. So it is admin and admin. Right, so you can see here, so it synced one user. So you created one user under user section. Here, if you have multiple users to specify, write that inside this one, and it will synchronize that. So whenever you want to do the synchronization, you have to execute this one. So once it is synchronized, so it will be available in LDAP, Ambari's credential. So now if you just refresh this one, yes, you can see this test one, and it is from LDAP. So you would be able to log in with this test user one. So initially there won't be any view configured for this one, so but still we will be able to log in. So let me try that here. So test user one, and the password, whatever the password we have set in Active Directory. Yes, I'm able to log in, but the views are not configured here, so that's why. So I can configure the view for this particular user, and that okay. So if I want to make that into admin user or anything, I can change from here, but there is no groups associated with this. Okay, so you can just check. Okay, so make it to an Ambari admin or any user. So now I will show you how we can synchronize the group. Okay, so for synchronizing group, so just create a file similarly with the name groups.txt. So you can write it in any name. So what I am doing here is, so here I have two groups, so developers and Hadoop admin. So I am writing these two groups in this file, and whoever is a member of these groups will be added here. See, I can see the members. See, these two users. So Hadoop admins. So let me add Hadoop admins. I think I have to write in a separate line or developers or comma separator. So I'm not sure. So I need to check it here. Developers. Okay. So Ambari hyphen server sync hyphen ldap hyphen hyphen groups, then this file, then credential admin admin. Okay, see, this is treating as Hadoop admins and developers in a single line. So let me modify that and write it in a comma separated way. So admin, yes, see, you can see five users, two groups are created and the five users are synchronized. I mean the whoever belongs to this group, so Hadoop admins, so these two users, and whoever belongs to this developers group, what are the members, so will be updated here. So if I log into the Ambari and manage it from here. So I can see the users created and the users section. So I can see all those users. Also from the group, I can see these two groups. Again, I can configure the views or I can configure the settings. So say for example, for Hadoop admin group, so I'm just providing this group for certain privileges so that I can add here. So cluster administrator, who are our cluster administrator group? See Hadoop admins. If I add Hadoop admins here and save it, so then whoever belongs to these groups, so Hadoop admin, these two users. So if I log into that user, so let me log into this particular user and try. Yes, I'm getting full admin access with this user. So this is how we can synchronize. So synchronizing, so we need to do these things in a periodic way. Say for example, if one of the users, from Hadoop admin, this user, I'm going to delete this user, right? So if I delete this user from here, still I would be able to log in with that user. Sorry. I think that is not here, but if to update that, so I can just execute this command. So here you can see that user is removed from Ambari. So this is how Ambari LDAP sync or Ambari Active Directory sync work. So you can easily integrate by using the simple step. I hope you are able to understand this topic. So if you have any questions, so please use the comment box and write your queries. So I will try to answer that. So also, if you have not subscribed to this channel, so please do. So you will get notifications when I upload another contents. So I will be uploading more contents over time. Thank you. Bye.